Hey, brothers and sisters, this is your very awesome Brother Patrick here in the Philippines. Hope you guys are doing all right. I wanted to make a video of the words. I've been working on the words list. I've had time because the Lord's been giving me so many dreams and stuff, brothers and sisters, like never before. And all kinds of stuff and all kinds of words and stuff that the Lord gave me to study when I've been praying. And I haven't even had a chance to hardly touch on it, brothers and sisters. So, anyway, I wanted to give a testimony. You know that I've had dozens of testimonies from people with the anointing oil that the Lord told me to make and send out, you know, to pray over and send the anointing, revival anointing out to people. And, I usually don't talk about it too much. But it's, you know, in my ministry, brothers and sisters, I started out as a pastor and then... as an assistant pastor, you know, now you know. And the whole thing is I was teaching Sunday school, and the Lord led me to get this book by Kenneth Hagin Sr., who's dead now. They call him Dad Hagin, and all about faith. The Lord had even shown me what one of the first visions I had was of the cover of that book, brothers and sisters. And I went and got that book, and I taught on faith about healing and all these things. And I wanted desired of the Lord to be operating in the gift of faith. And some spirit-filled singing pastors came by to the church who I ended up getting ordained with later on. I had a license. You get a license to preach, and then you can be ordained if you're like the senior pastor. That's what most churches do. So I admit was licensed there with this Mission Baptist. And anyways, I got later on ordained with this Pentecostal group. Anyway, I didn't know these people from Church of God. And I'd been praying for the gift of healing. I've mentioned this testimony before. There was a woman that kept having seizures in the church. And the people were like saying she's just trying to get attention. She needs to go to the doctor. All this alleged Christians there. And anyway, I'd been praying with her. Every time I'd lay hands on her and pray, her seizure would stop. And then when I'd stop praying with her, they would come back. And so I'd been praying for several weeks and had been teaching on the gifts of the Spirit and all this and faith by a great workbook. You can find it online, a PDF download of Faith by Kenneth Hagin workbook. It's like a workbook. And that's what I was teaching out of. And it's a very good book for beginners of walking by faith. And anyhow... this brother told me, he gave me a word from the Lord. I never heard about, or never seen anybody give a word or any, I'd never seen anybody speak in tongues in person or anything. Not even, it's before the, I was really online in those days. There was no YouTube or anything. This was in March 2001. Anyway, so this pastor, brother, Arthur P. Kane Jr. is his name. He said to me, I need to anoint you with oil and give you a word from the Lord, brother. And this was on a Sunday night in a Baptist church, and we were having as a matter of fact, they were having a special singing that night, so the Lord had it timed out right, and I was on the front row right in front of the speakers where people couldn't hear me. And anyway, this brother kept saying, hey, I need to anoint you with oil. I said, well, let's wait till after the service. He's like, no, I got to do it now. So went off to the side of the church, every little Baptist church has a piano on one side and an organ on the other. We went over there behind the organ, maybe it was, on the right side. I mean, it's a piano, whatever. And he anointed me with oil. The pastor actually had oil. He anointed me with the oil. And he gave me a word. I'd never seen anybody give it. You know, it was a prophetic word. Saying that, you know, my son, you've been seeking the gift of healing. Now, this guy knew that, but I hadn't talked to him about it. It was a word of knowledge. You've been seeking the gift of healing. Then he gave me a word of wisdom. Before you can receive the gift of healing, you first must be baptized in the Holy Ghost. Okay? So I was like, well, I didn't know exactly what all that meant, but I was like, awesome, you know. And I felt the presence of the Lord. He anointed my hands, he anointed my forehead, and said God would give me hands of healing. And so I went back and, you know, back to the front row. I was sitting on the front row with this hymn and some other, from the singing group. They were taking turns singing on this Sunday night. And special numbers, Southern gospel music. And there's a whole group of them. Anyway, and then all of a sudden, about 15 minutes later, the Holy Spirit fell on me. And a river of living water came out of my belly. And it was as if someone had put their hands over my ears. And it was like muffled, the sound. And then I felt, you know, like the hand of an angel, obviously, it felt like was holding my chin and moving my chin, brothers and sisters. And a river of living water came out of my stomach. It felt like, you know, like if you were going to throw up. But it wasn't a nauseating feeling. I didn't feel bad or anything like that. But it was like the same kind of a similar force, but it felt good, of coming up from your belly, a river of living water. I began to speak in a language that I did not know, and then nobody could hear me. But he was standing right beside me, and he heard it. And then the Holy Spirit moved, brothers and sisters. The pastor, to his credit, got up there in the front and said, I'm not going to preach tonight. We're just going to continue with the special singings. God's doing something, but I don't know what. And so people in the church, there's about 65 people there that night, they came to the altar one at a time to be prayed for. I went and prayed with each person. And I didn't know, even at that time, that they didn't, the Baptist preachers didn't lay hands on people. I'd read in the Bible about, you know, laying hands on people. So I did that. I laid hands on each person, and every person got their prayers answered. Most of them were healings, brothers and sisters. Most of them were healings. Even people that were not there, they were praying for a relative in another country, and they got healed, all kinds of stuff. You know, and from then on, God used me mightily in the healing ministry, and that's what I did in the Philippines. Until I started the YouTube channel, I did evangelism, I did pastors' conferences on end times teaching and on how to do evangelism, and I did evangelism crusades with healing and some prophetic. And then since I started YouTube, the Lord has moved me a whole lot more into prophetic. But anyway, brothers and sisters, the anointing oil we're sending people that the Lord told me to do is a point of contact to bring revival and healing for salvations and all that, you know, that would bring the spirit of conviction on people. It's a point of contact. I prayed over it. I asked Brother Sid, you know, I was living right down the road from Brother Sid. He laid hands on it. We prayed in agreement. Also, and then we prayed with some of the oil right here on one or two of my videos. We prayed over the oil. And I had that oil there with me every day when I was doing my praise and worship. You know, so when I made about 30 bottles I left for Brother Sid. I think there's a few left. But anyway, when I get back, of course, I've got still got a whole liter that we've been praying over. I had like 4 liters. Sister gave me, I think, 4 liters of oil. And so I've still got at least 1 or maybe 2 liters of oil left that I kept right there with me when I was praying all the time I was in South Carolina. And so anyway, I want to read one praise report. I've had dozens of praise reports. I get a praise report almost every day. Someone that received the baptism of the Holy Spirit by watching my video, pray to receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit. People that got healed. I've done a few videos praying for healing. All these things. You know, I never talk about these things, brothers and sisters. I don't ever talk about the things I've done in the ministry. But, you know, testimonies brings faith. You know, people get faith when they hear about other people's testimonies. And I prayed, brothers and sisters, and I've led, God has used me to lead tens of thousands of people to salvation. That's number one. Always. You know, I preached one time. As a matter of fact, I went to a Baptist church, and I thought the Lord was going to have me preach, which I do lots of times, about how, you know, you guys are not, you know, speaking in tongues. You're not operating in the power of the Holy Spirit, and people need to be healed and all that. There's lots of sick people with no money here in the mountainous. This was in a very remote mountainous area where the New People's Army, the NPA rebels, actually were there, and this was in one of their areas. And the name of the place was called Song Pit. And I went there. It's a place that I gave a guitar to that Baptist church. We bought a guitar and sent that up to there to them. I took pictures of that, and I made a video about that a long time ago. I took the Bible. We had a Bible school. I had a Bible school here that I did for 2 or 3 years, and I took the students with me. They were there with me. The house dad of Orphanage Number 1 was one of my students. He was there with me. I was, you know, and lots of times the Lord would use me to speak that with Baptists. But at this time, I got up there and said, Jesus said, if you're right out of fins, you plug it out. You know, it's better to enter heaven with one eye than to enter hell with both eyes. You know, and if you're right hand of fins, you cut it off. It's better to enter heaven with one good hand than to enter hell with two bad hands if it's causing you to sin. And so that's what I started talking about, that how important salvation is as opposed to people being healed. It doesn't do any good for anybody to be healed if they're going to go to hell. You know, it's spiritual healing is number one. So that's always true. Salvation is always right. That's why, brothers and sisters, when I go to remote areas, if there's any pastor and he's preaching true evangelism and he's willing to go to these dangerous areas and do evangelism, I'll go with him. Most of the time, they are Baptist preachers. Sometimes they're United Pentecostal preachers. As long as they agree that salvation is by grace through faith and that salvation is not being baptized in Jesus' name, that a ceremonial act does not save you, a work, but by grace are you saved through faith, not of your own, but a gift of God, not by works, lest any man should boast. As long as they will agree with me with that, I don't care what denomination they're from. I will go there with them and for evangelism. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I've already been rambling for 10 minutes. Let me read this testimony. Like I said, I get testimonies almost every day, but this was a cool one, and she sent it to me. She asked me to talk about it. Okay, hi, this is Brittany P. I took off their last name when I put it on my thing here because I would surely say her last name if I wrote it on there. Here in California, I just wanted to tell you that I've been praying and using the oil I got from you. My six-year-old daughter has been going to the dentist for 2 days in a row, and at home my baby was hurting so bad. I just grabbed her cheek and prayed, and it started feeling good, and then prayed again with the oil, and she had no pain since. I also used it on a tooth. My friend Pam, she was carrying in bags from the store, and her hand started cramping. I rubbed oil on it and prayed, and the pain was gone. My little cousin Ricky, who is 17, suffering from allergies his whole life, I prayed over him and put the oil on him and asked him about a week later if he had any more allergies, and he said he was healed. I also went to a carnival in my town, and while waiting in line for a ride, I poured some oil in a Ziploc bag for a woman. Then I produced to anoint every person, child, in that line with the oil. I think I embarrassed my mom a lot, right, of course, but also to the glory of God. Well, and then she's saying that, she said, you know, please talk about it. And I will write again about it, more details. Well, anyway, I just went in and read that, and I just got another testimony. You know, I decided to finally give, you know, one of the testimonies what people gave me about the anointing oil. And then someone just gave me another testimony just before I made this video, before I prayed, saying that her brother, you know, she thought he had some demons or whatever. He kept being sick, and she anointed him with the oil, and then he had to vomit. And after he vomited, he felt great. And that's true, brothers and sisters. I've been involved in lots of deliverances, and then if you read books about it too, you'll see that when people are truly delivered from demons, they'll vomit almost 100% of the time. You know, it's coming out of their spirit. As I mentioned, just like being baptized in the Holy Spirit, you have this river of living water coming up from your spirit, and it comes out with a flooding river of the Holy Spirit. When you get baptized in the Holy Spirit, what's flowing out of you is God, the breath of God. That's why the real, you know, the name of the Holy Spirit is the Ruach Elohim, the breath of God, just like what he breathed on Adam, brothers and sisters. Now, the other people, a lot of people like to use this other Kadosh also, but Ruach Elohim, the breath of God, is one of the names of the Holy Spirit given in the Word of God, the breath of God. And then and then when people have a demon, you know, it's still coming out from their spirit. It's down in their spirit, man. It's coming out as real vomit. As something bad, as a manifestation, oh, that demon's coming out of the person. So praise God for that, brothers and sisters. Praise God. And so I think I have a few bottles of oil left, and I haven't mentioned anything about it because, you know, Brother Sid is doing it for me as a favor. I don't want to put any burden on him, and I only had a few bottles. And I think we've sent out most of them and most of the books. I left some books with him, too. I haven't said anything about it. Also, while I'm thinking about brothers and sisters, it's time for the boxes again. Sister Pearlie in the Facebook group. I have her information there. Please, if you want to send some stuff, please, right under this video, is please join the Facebook group of Joshua's Ministry. And then I have the Sister Pearlie's information to send stuff to her for the orphans and the street kids and all that, like children's summer clothes, shoes, Christian children's storybooks, crayons, school supplies, anything like that. Sister Pearlie, we've already sent boxes 3 or 4 times. If you're in the California area, I haven't heard from the Opingas there in California if they're going to send boxes again. But last time, they've sent a set of boxes, and then, you know, we didn't have much time. But people would send, if you're in the California area, maybe to them. I don't know if it's cheaper anywhere in the U.S. Sister Pearlie is up near Chicago area. Anyway, let me do these words, brothers and sisters. I've already been rambling on for a long time. I ask you guys to pray over each of these words that I'm going to give, because our prayers are outside of time, and it doesn't matter, brothers and sisters, as I always say. I also want to tell you, you know, I get dozens of praise reports from the words that the Lord gave me, mostly words of wisdom. You know, word of knowledge, as I've said, and a word of knowledge is like the Lord told me that you've been doing drugs. It's a word of knowledge. But if the Lord said, hey, you need to stop doing drugs and maybe you're so addicted you need to go to AA or whatever, whatever. That's a word of wisdom. What to do with the knowledge. Knowledge is knowing something is going on. Oh, the Lord said you haven't been able to sleep for a week. Word of wisdom, what to do about it. You need to pray more or whatever. Okay, Jackie W., first one. Let's pray for these people. Brothers and sisters, right now, Father, we speak your spirit and covering of your blood over every one of these words and every one of these people, brothers and sisters in Christ. We speak your blessings upon them, Father, in the name of Jesus. Amen. Sister Jackie W., lay aside every weight that does easily beset you and run the race set before you. That's the word of the Lord for you, Jackie W. That's from Hebrews. I believe that's chapter 12. Paulette J., sight unseen is the plan the Lord has prepared for you. So the Lord has a plan for you and you haven't seen it yet. You don't know what it is. He hasn't showed it to you yet, Paulette. He hasn't showed it to you yet, Paulette. Keith R., special mark on you as a sign from the Lord. That's a pretty interesting word right there. Special mark on you as a sign from the Lord. Not the mark of the beast now. A special mark on you as a sign from the Lord. It's not the mark of the beast. It's like a good thing. Linka. L-E-N-K-A. Linka. Decadence. And I heard this. Decadence. I heard the word plum, and I don't know what that means. And Council of Fire. Decadence, Plum, and Council of Fire. Some of these brothers and sisters I got a word for. And I need to give it to you privately. Bert H., I need to send you a private word. And also our brother Andrew. I already sent him his private word. Brother Bert, I will also send yours privately. Bert H., I ask you, Bert H., if you know how to get the private messages or email, to email me and I will give you your word. I'm not giving any, I want to give some words in private because it's personal. It's not just like a straight up exhortation. Not necessarily bad, but you know what I'm saying, it's a personal word. Jacqueline K. Salvation and sanctification are of me, says the Lord. Jacqueline K. Salvation and sanctification are of me, says the Lord. Rhonda E., try not, do not, be not. Rhonda A., Rhonda E., try not, do not, be not. Chaz Dunn, C-H-A-S, Dunn. Drew, I think it's like past tense of draw, drew the hash mark, signed it in the sand, sealed it in favor, lofty heights of rapture. That's the word I got. Drew, like past tense, the hash mark, signed it in the sand, sealed it in favor, lofty heights of rapture. Roxanna W., and my sister more than me, Shelly T. Pestilence is abounding. Sound knowledge is sounding. Listen, 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 Shelly. That's for Shelly. Roxanna, that's for your sister, Shelly T. Pestilence is abounding. Sounding knowledge is sounding. Sound knowledge is sounding. Listen, 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 Shelly. I can make a deduction from this. You know, pestilence, bad things are going on. Your tribulation is coming and you need to listen probably to your sister, Roxanna. I assume that's probably what it is, you know. That's my personal opinion of what it probably means. Laurie B. I've had the time of my life and I owe it all to you. And that's like, you know, you are singing that to the Lord. I've had, like that song, now I've had the time of my life and I owe it all to you. It's like what you would say unto the Lord. Maria C. I guess. M-A-R-I-E. Sorry, I don't, you know, I'm tired. M-A-R-I-E-C. Cancel the plans and reset your desires in me. Marie C. Cancel the plans and reset your desires in me. Now this is name number two equals TB. Name number two equals TB. So I can't remember why I wrote that or if that's what someone put in their message. The sky is the limit. Name number two equals TB. The sky is the limit. Andrew J., I already gave him his word privately, and I got to remember to go back and give Brother Bert H. If you haven't heard from me, Brother H., Bert H., you need to email me so I can give you this word, because email me. I'm pretty busy in keeping up with all these names. I ask you to email me if you want the word. Nick P., focus your time, focus your heart. Seek my help in all things speedily, I shall hear and respond. Nick P., focus your time, focus your heart. Seek my help in all things speedily, I shall hear and respond. Stefan K., S-T-E-F-A-N. Cook and clean and light the candle and wait. Stefan K. Cook and clean, light the candle and wait. Connie R. Sacrifice and service is the life in Christ with eternal rewards. For did I not say those who lose their life shall find it? Connie R. Sacrifice and service is the life in Christ with eternal rewards. For did I not say those who lose their life shall find it? Peggy L., I believe it is. It's not Peggy I., it's Peggy L. Stranger things have happened to those who believe. I want to see if that's L or... That is an L. Peggy L., I do believe. Stranger things have happened to those who believe. Lisa D., for God causes all things to work together for the good of those who love Him. That's Romans 8:28. Lisa D., for God causes all things to work together for the good of those who love Him. Peter G., devices of humor are good. What's good for the goose is good for the gander. Peter G., I thought it was Peter Griffith, I don't know. Devices of humor are good. What's good for the goose is good for the gander. Joanna, or Joanne T., stand your ground, and in Christ you shall be found. Joanne T., stand your ground, and in Christ you shall be found. Yana Lynn, divide and conquer is the plan of the man, but God unites us unto Himself. Lace up, pack up, dress up, you're going to a wedding. That sounds pretty good. Yana Lynn, divide and conquer is the plan of the man, but God unites us unto Himself. Lace up, pack up, dress up, you're going to a wedding. Kelly T., I prayed about this one several times. And I don't know if it's for you specifically or the Lord wants you to hear this. Not like, I don't know. Kelly with an I-T. Tribulation and wrath abides on those who are not with me. Satan, what have I to do with thee? Kelly T. Now, like I said, I don't know if this is for you or something you're dealing with. You're dealing with someone in spiritual warfare or whatever, a relative, whatever. Hear the word of the Lord, Kelly T. Tribulation and wrath abides on those who are not with me. Satan, what have I to do with thee? Okay, brothers and sisters, that's as far as I've got. I've still got several more names here. Robert M., Rebecca V., Wendy Joan, Pauline C., Connie M., Lucy G., Manuel C., Wendy Forever, Renee H., and Rebecca C. So there you go. That's the names I got left on my list. So I will do those next time. I run out of steam. I can only do about 10 or 15, and then I just can't think anymore. I can't do it anymore at a time. God bless you guys, and unless, of course, the Lord would let me. God bless you guys. God bless you. In Jesus' name.